In this video, I'm going to talk about the bubble plugins that I really enjoy using and save me a lot of time in my bubble apps. Some of these bubble plugins I only learned about recently, and I wish I knew about them a lot sooner. So hopefully they'll be helpful for you to know about as you build in bubble. If you want to learn how to build your own applications using bubble, check the link in the description to go to No-Code MBA's Building Apps with Bubble course. The first plugin that I'd recommend using is Hero Icons. This is a plugin that allows you to use Hero Icons, which are SVG icons by the makers of Tailwind CSS, and it allows you to really easily add these icons into your Bubble app. So the default icons that Bubble uses are, in my opinion, just okay. They do make it really easy to add it into your app, but I don't think it looks as nice or as modern as these hero icons do. So it's completely free. You just add the hero icons plugin into your Bubble app, and then you can add it in. So I'll show you real quick what the difference is. So here I am in my app, and I'm going to search for icon. And by doing that, you can see icon is coming up, and so is hero icon. These are also other icons that are coming up from the hero icon plugin. But we really just need the hero icon element here. So I'm going to pull in an icon. And I'm also going to pull in a hero icon. I'll just show you the difference of why I like the hero icon a little bit more. So here they are. So let's say I just want a notification bell. So here it is. And then let's compare it to this notification bell. I really just chose these completely randomly. So we'll see the difference here. Might be bell. Here we go. And there we go. So that's the difference. You know, you can make up your own mind, but in my opinion, the hero icon just looks more modern and a little bit nicer. And I think it's like that pretty much across the board. The next plugin that I use all the time, and this is an obvious one, is the API connector. So this is one that you probably do know about if you use Bubble. So I'm not going to spend too much time talking about it, but I use it a lot these days, especially for connecting to AI APIs. So you can see in this app that I have connections to Claude, to OpenAI, to a bunch of different Pinecone is another AI API, but you can also connect to things like Stripe. I'm connected to Webflow in this app. I'm connected to Assembly AI. This is another AI transcription service that I use. So there's a lot of APIs here that I have in my app, and they're all connected through the API connector. Another one that I like to use is called Air Copy to Clipboard. Now, what this does is it allows you to really easily have a button in your Bubble app. You can click it, and then it will copy text to a user's clipboard. So think about an example where you want to, let's say you have a link, a custom link that you want users to be able to copy and share with other people to join their team or take some action. This is a really easy way to do that. You have a button, it's copied to the user's clipboard, and then they can paste it elsewhere. So something that I use a lot. Another one I want to talk about is 1T CSV Uploader. This is really helpful for uploading a CSV, mapping headers to the column header in the appropriate fields in Bubble, and being able to do, I think it's up to like 10,000 rows in one upload. So this is really helpful, something that I use. Bubble doesn't have a really easy way to do this built in, so something I would definitely recommend. Another one I recommend checking out is ChatGPT/LLM Toolkit with streaming. What's nice about this is it allows you to build a chatbot within your app that has streaming responses. So the difference between a streaming response and a normal, typical response with an API call is the streaming response in AI will start kind of writing the response, kind of what you might be familiar with ChatGPT, and it will start writing it before it's actually finished the full generation. If you don't use this plugin, you have to send the API call, wait for it to finish, and then it gets sent back to you. So this is nice if you want that type of UI on your app. So I would definitely recommend checking this one out. The last plugin that I want to talk about is Fuzzy Search and Autocomplete. Now, what this does is allows you to have a search box. Users can search, and then it will automatically update the results on your page in real time. So I find this to be a really helpful plugin. It's something that, again, isn't really that easy to do in Bubble natively. So this is something that I actually use. Thanks for watching. Hopefully you found this video useful. Again, if you want to learn how to build your own applications using Bubble, check out the link in the description to go to NoCode MBA's Building Apps with Bubble course. And I'll see you in the next video.